Good morning.
Good morning.
So good to see you all. Happy Father's Day to all those who are dads and stepdads and granddads and uncles and everybody, all those moms who are dads too, as you celebrate your Father's Day. Happy Father's Day. Oh, well, thank you very much. I appreciate that. There's an announcement from Waterford United Church on Friday, June 24th at 7:30. There is going to be a free concert featuring Angus Sinclair. If you've seen the Free Cantors, then you know who Angus Sinclair is. Their company and a First Nations vocalist named Alban. And that's followed by a Strawberry Social to offset the cost of the instrument maintenance, Strawberry Shortcake Desserts, $5. But this says the concert is free. So, if you want to go hear Angus play and hear this young lady sing, go to me. Let us begin our worship as we stand and sing our opening hymn. Joyful, joyful, we adore thee, number 425.
Praise you for your glory.
O God, our defender, storms rage about us and cause us to be afraid. Rescue your people from despair. Deliver your sons and daughters from fear, and preserve us all from unbelief. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the proclamation of God's name.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Ahab told Jezebel that all Elijah had done and how he had killed all the prophets with the sword. Then Jezebel sent a messenger to Elijah, saying, "So may the God speak to me, and more also, if I do not make your life like the life of one of them by this time tomorrow." Then he was afraid. He got up and fled for his life, and came to Beersheba, which belongs to Judah. He left his servant there, but he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness, and came and sat down under a solitary broom tree. He asked that he might die. "It is enough now, O Lord, take away my life, for I am no better than my ancestors." Then he lay down under the broom tree and fell asleep. Suddenly an angel touched him and said to him, "Get up and eat." He looked, and there at his head was a cake baked on hot stones and a jar of water. He ate and drank and lay down again. The angel of the Lord came a second time, touched him and said, "Get up and eat. Otherwise, the journey will be too much for you." He got up and ate and drank, and then he went in with the strength of that food 40 days and 40 nights to Horeb, the Mount of God. At that place, he came to a cave and spent the night there. Then the word of the Lord came to him, saying, "What are you doing here, Elijah?" He answered, "I have been very zealous for the Lord, the God of hosts. The Israelites have forsaken your covenant. Throw down your altars and kill your prophets with the sword. I alone am left, and they are seeking my life to take it away." He said, "Go out and stand on the mountain before the Lord is about to pass by." There was a great wind so strong that it was splitting mountains and breaking rocks in pieces before the Lord. But the Lord was not the wind. And after the wind, an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. And after the earthquake, a fire. But the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire, a sound of sheer silence. When Elijah heard it, he wrapped his face in his mantle and went out and stood at the entrance of the cave. Then there came a voice to him that said, "What are you doing here, Elijah?" He answered, "I have been very zealous for the Lord, the God of hosts, for the Israelites have forsaken your covenant. Throw down your altars and killed your prophets with the sword. I alone am left, and they are seeking my life to take it away." Then the Lord said to him, "Go, return on your way to the wilderness of Damascus." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We're going to read two psalms together today, Psalm 42 and Psalm 43, starting on page 758. As the deer longs for the water brooks,
so longs my soul for you,
my soul is athirst for God, athirst for the living God.
When shall I come to appear?
My tears have been my food day and night.
All day long they say to me, "Where now is your God?"
I pour out my soul when I think on these things. With the voice of praise and thanksgiving.
Among those who keep all the day.
Why are you so full of heaviness, O my soul?
And why are you so disquieted within me?
Put your trust in God.
For I will yet give thanks to him, who is the help of my confidence and my God.
My soul is heavy within me.
Therefore, I remember you.
One deep calls to another in the noise of your cataracts. The Lord grants his loving kindness in the daytime. I will say to the God of my strength, why have you forgotten me?
And why do I go so
while my bones are being broken?
My enemies mock me to my face.
All day long they mock me.
And say to me, where are you now, God?
Why are you so full of heaviness, O my soul?
And why are you so disquieted?
Put your trust in God.
For I will yet give thanks to him, who lifts up all my confidence and my God.
Let us pray. Gracious God, in the night of distress, we forget the days of sun and joy. Even when we do not know your presence, preserve us from the dark torrent of despair. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
And Psalm 43. Give judgment for me, O God, and defend my cause against an ungodly people.
Deliver me from this evil.
For you are the God of my strength. Why have you put me up from you?
And why do I go so heavily while the enemy oppresses me?
Send out your light and your truth, that they may lead me.
And bring me to your holy covenant, to your true honor.
That I may go to the altar of God, to the God of my joy and gladness.
And on my heart I will give thanks to you, O God.
Why are you so full of heaviness, O my soul?
And why are you so despised within me?
Put your trust in God.
For I will yet give thanks to him, who is the help of my confidence and my God.
Let us pray. God of mercy, deliver those who are weighed down by fear and depression, and give them joy and gladness in your presence. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Galatians. Now before faith came, we were imprisoned and guarded under the law until faith would be revealed. Therefore the law was our disciplinarian until Christ came, so that we might be justified by faith. But now that faith has come, we are no longer subject to a disciplinarian. For in Christ Jesus, you are all children of God through faith. As many of you as were baptized into Christ have clothed yourself with Christ. There is no longer Jew or Greek. There is no longer slave or free. There is no longer male and female. For all of you are one in Christ Jesus. And if you belong to Christ, then you are Abraham's offspring, heirs according to the promise. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Then Jesus and the disciples arrived at the country of the Gerasenes, which is opposite Galilee. As he stepped out on land, a man of the city who had demons met him. For a long time he had worn no clothes, and he did not live in a house, but in the tombs. When he saw Jesus, he fell down before him and shouted at the top of his voice, "What have you to do with me, Jesus, Son of the Most High God? I beg you, do not torment me." For Jesus had commanded the unclean spirit to come out of the man. For many times it had seized him. He was kept under guard and bound with chains and shackles, but he would break the bonds and be driven by the demon into the wilds. Jesus then asked him, "What is your name?" He said, "Legion," for many demons had entered him. They begged him not to order them to go back into the abyss. Now there on the hillside a large herd of swine was feeding, and the demons begged Jesus to let them enter these. So he gave them permission. Then the demons came out of the man and entered the swine, and the herd rushed down the steep bank into the lake and was drowned. When the swineherds saw what had happened, they ran off and told it in the city and in the country. Then people came out to see what had happened, and when they came to Jesus, they found the man from whom the demons had gone, sitting at the feet of Jesus, clothed and in his right mind, and they were afraid. Those who had seen it told them how the one who had been possessed by demons had been healed. Then all the people of the surrounding country of the Gerasenes asked Jesus to leave them, for they were seized with a great fear. So he got into the boat and returned to Galilee. The man from whom the demons had gone begged that he might be with him, but Jesus sent him away, saying, "Return to your home and declare how much God has done for you." So the man went away, proclaiming throughout the city how much Jesus had done for him. Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I speak to you in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. One of the things I really appreciate about the Book of Alternative Services are the collects that have been written for each Sunday throughout the church year. And the one today just seems really appropriate given the scriptures that we just read. O God, our defender, storms rage about us and cause us to be afraid. Rescue your people from despair. Deliver your sons and daughters from fear, and preserve us from all unbelief. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Elijah's situation fits very well into this collect, into these thoughts, and the psalmist repeats again and again, my soul, why are you so heavy? Instead of being heavy, trust in the Lord and everything will be fine. We know that not every time we do that, everything will be fine. But we will know that we have God's presence in our hearts, and that we can trust that. We can trust that presence, that presence, that God is close to us as our hearts, close to us as our breath, and that when we place our trust in that presence, in that experience of God, we need not despair. We need not fear for our spirits. There are times when we find ourselves in situations where our very lives are in the balance. But knowing that God's presence is with us gives us courage and strength to deal with the adversity that's in front of us. It's not going to make the adversity go away. God doesn't promise us a rose garden, as somebody once said. But he gives us the ability to deal with it. So Elijah has... Elijah, I need to say something first about violence in the Old Testament. This commentary on Elijah's experience. Elijah had a contest with the prophets of Baal, another religion in the area that Queen Jezebel had imported into Israel and was now competing against Judaism and had become quite popular. So Elijah has this contest with the prophets of Baal atop of Mount Carmel and to see who could ignite a fire just by prayer, whose God was stronger, Baal or Jehovah. And Elijah won the contest. It's a wonderful description of the contest. So when you get a chance, go home and read it. But at the end of the contest, after Elijah won, he felt that God was telling him to slaughter all the prophets of Baal. And that is what happened. It's difficult for me to reconcile this kind of violence in the Old Testament with the God that we know through Jesus Christ. It just doesn't seem compatible to me that the God that we know through Jesus would ask his servants to do such a thing. There's a lot of violence in the Old Testament that is attributed to God. God told us to do this, and so we did it. Committing mass genocide all over the place in their pursuit of the promised land. So when we read this stuff in the Old Testament, we need to put it in the context of the whole of Scripture, all the Scripture that we know, all that we know about Jesus' life and ministry and example. And we need to question those parts that just don't fit with what we know about a loving God. A loving God wouldn't tell us to do it. And I think a lot of the gun violence that takes place these days can be attributed somewhat to that. So, just a heads up. So Elijah has been threatened with his life because he slaughtered the prophets of Baal. Queen Jezebel, whose prophets they were, threatened Elijah's life. She says she's going to kill him. And so he runs away. He escapes into the wilderness, and he sits in the wilderness under a broom tree, and he just wants to die. He feels this is the end of the road for him. He feels that he has nowhere to go. All these people are pursuing him. You can read some of that in the psalm, his soul is disquieted. He wants to die. And in the middle of his despair, God sends an angel to minister to him, to give him food. And then God himself shows himself to Elijah. It's a remarkable thing. It seldom happens in the Old Testament. Elijah is told to sit in the mouth of a cave on Mount Horeb, which is a sacred mountain. And there was an earthquake, and there was a fire, and there was tremendous natural violence. But God was not in any of those signs, any of those activities. Instead, there was stillness and quiet and peacefulness. And out of this quiet came a still, small, speaking to Elijah and getting him up on his feet and back to the ministry that he had been called to as a prophet. So when we are faced with those kinds of threats to our feeling of well-being, to our confidence, our trust may have been shaken by somebody or some institution. We may have financial problems, we may have family problems, we may have illness ourselves or illness in the family. All these kinds of things could lead us to despair. But instead, God says to us, I am with you in your heart. I walk with you through this valley, through this dark valley, this valley of shadow of death sometimes, and I will be with you. And we can draw comfort and strength and confidence from God's presence in this way. Whatever you're facing, whatever I'm facing, we can get through it. We can deal with the adversity because God loves us. He sent his only son to die for us. He sent Jesus into the world not to condemn the world, but to redeem it. And so we walk with God. Jesus is with us, and the Holy Spirit works in us to equip us not just to face adversity, but equips us to continue the ministry to which he has called us on, the ministry of announcing the good news to all those around us. We know people who need good news. We know people who are living with despair, tragedy, loss, grief. Maybe they need to hear this good news. May the Holy Spirit enable us and encourage us to share this good news and be a means of God's blessing to them. Amen. We continue as we confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. Let us confess the faith of our baptism as we say,
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate. He was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The prayers of the people are on page 126, litany number 18. Sit, stand, or kneel as you will come. We pray for our World Vision children, Dennis, Jose, and Baldwin. In the parish chain of prayer, we pray for Michelle Lopshin. In our diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for the people and clergy of St. Augustine of Canterbury, Windsor, St. David and St. Mark, Windsor, and St. James, Windsor. Ask your prayers for Susan and I and our family. The flowers of the altar today are placed to the glory of God by Susan and I in memory of our dads, J. John Brown, Gordon Spry, and our son, David Brown. In peace we pray to you, Lord God. For all people in their daily life and work.
For our families, for our neighbors, for all those who are alone.
For this community, for Delhi, Otterville, Norwich, Brantford, our country, Canada, and wherever there is violence and injustice in the world, especially remembering the Ukraine. For all
the world, for justice, freedom, and peace.
For the just and proper use of your creation.
For the victims of hunger, fear, justice, and oppression.
We remember our farming community this day. For all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble.
For those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy.
For the peace and unity of the Church of God.
For all who claim the gospel, and all who seek the truth.
We pray for St. Stephen's Episcopal Church in the United States, where there was a shooting. For Todd, our bishop, for Linda, our primate, and our metropolitan, Sydney, the international Indigenous Archbishop, Marinez, the bishop of Amazonia, and her people, and for Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury. For all bishops and other ministers.
For all who serve God in this church.
For our own needs and those of others. Today especially, we pray for George and Lisa, for Rita, Marilyn, Lance, Jerry, Wendy, Layla, Pat, Frida, Renee, and Melissa, and all those known in our hearts alone.
Pray for Atlas,
Rebecca and Ron,
Sean. Hear us, Lord.
For your mercy is great.
We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life. I give thanks for our dads. We will exalt you, O God, our King.
And praise your name forever and ever.
We pray for all those who have died in the peace of Christ, and for those whose faith is known to you alone, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom.
Norma Ford.
Gord and John and David. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them.
Let them trust in you.
We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father.
In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in the midst of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Dear friends, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please greet one another in the name of the Lord.
That's it.
Let us continue as we present our gifts before God, and we sing our offertory hymn, number 617, Jesus and Mary Thought of Me.
Through Moses, you led your people from bondage into freedom. Through the prophets, you renewed your promise of salvation. Therefore, with them and with all your saints who have served you in every age, we give thanks and raise our voices to proclaim the glory of your name. Gracious God, his perfect sacrifice destroys the power of sin and death. By raising him to life, you give us life forevermore. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will
offer you, Father, this bread and this cup. Send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts, that all who eat and drink at this table may be one body and one holy people, a living sacrifice in Jesus Christ our Lord. Through Christ, with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now as our Savior is taught us, we are bold to pray. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry. Whoever believes in me will never thirst.
Thanks be to the Lord. Happy birthday from Preston.
These are the gifts of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
guide and protect your people who share in this sacred mystery, and keep us always in your love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we pray together, glory to God, who is the power of working in us, and to infinitely more than we can ask or imagine.
Glory to God from generation to generation, in the Church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever.
Amen. And the peace of God, which passes all of our understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you this day and always. Amen. Let us sing our recessional hymn, God Be the Lord, number 371.
Thank you.